Joshua Wong, Ivan Lam, and Agnes Chow, former members of the pro-democratic organization Demosisto, were charged with illegal assembly because of their participation in the anti-extradition bill demonstrations last year. During the court session on July 6, Joshua Wong refused to plead guilty. He emphasized that he will not surrender to the communist regime and that he hopes more people will continue to fight for democracy. At the same time, he urged the leaders in every country to act and support the Hong Kong people's fight for democracy.
Any prime minister or president around the world, they should realize Hong Kong turned to be the new authoritarian era, and they should not keep silence.
The Hong Kong police headquarters was surrounded by protesters on June 21st last year, when the anti-extradition bill protest was at its peak. The three former members of Demosisto were charged with inciting others, organizing, and participating in an unauthorized assembly. The plea hearing occurred on July 6.
We will not kowtow to the communist regime. We still hope to encourage more people continue to engage in the democracy movement. Even they ban my book in public library, they can't ignore and silence the voice of Hong Kong people. With the belief of Hong Kong people to fight for freedom, we will never give up and surrender to Beijing.
The three defendants were released on bail and will return to court on August 5th. Joshua Wong and Ivan Lam have denied all accusations. Agnes Chow decided to plead guilty, considering her lack of a criminal record and the possibility she will be given a different sentence. With other protesters facing more critical difficulties, she urged everyone to not give up their beliefs in freedom and democracy, whether they plead guilty or not.
It's one's own decision to plead guilty or not guilty. The extensive judicial procedures, different bail conditions, and restrictions on personal freedom and freedom of movement are all part of political suppression.
Joshua Wong indicated that the national security law doesn't target a small group of people. It affects the daily life of Hong Kong people. It will bring about more censorship in libraries, schools, and all types of governmental services. The slogan, "Liberate Hong Kong," is banned by authorities. Will the slogans, "Five Demands" and "Hong Kong People Stay Strong" also be banned in the future?
Direct censorship, just like what happened in China, is the things that we never imagined in the past.
Liberate Hong Kong, the revolution of our times is now banned. We don't know where Beijing's red line is or what the Hong Kong government's definition of moving the goalposts is. In the future, will the slogan "Five Demands, Not One Less" be banned from the streets, and will the slogan "Hong Kong People Stay Strong" be considered an extension of Hong Kong independence?